Hello students, welcome to my mess class once again. So in the last class I have done up to exercise 9b of chapter number 9. So today I shall start from 9c. Okay, what to say, exercise 9c. So see question number 1. A shopkeeper bought a second hand car for 1,50,000. He spent 10,000 on its painting and repair, and then sold it for 2 lakhs. Find his profit or loss. So in this case, what we need to find the what profit or loss in this transaction. So let us see. See question number
one. So 9C question number
one. So right. CP for the car will be what? 1,50,000.
So write CP for the car.
CP means cost price. CP means what? Cost price. That means what? If I buy a pen from the what? If I buy a pen from the what? From shop. Okay. Then if the pen cost what? Rupees 5. Then CP for this pen equals to what? 5 rupees. That means what? Cost price. Okay. Buying price. And what if I sell, then it is called what? SP, selling price. Okay, so CP means what? Cost price. Okay, so in short form I am writing. Okay, so cost price for second hand car. So what cost price?
Cost price for the car equals to what? 1 lakh rupees. 1,50,000.
Then what? He spent what? More 10,000 on what? Paintings and repairing.
So right. Money spent in painting and repairing. In painting and repairing. Close to what? 10,000. Money spent in painting and repairing.
This is what? 10,000.
Money spent in painting and repairing equals to what? 10,000. Therefore, total CP will be what? This what? 1,50,000 plus what? 10,000. Because it has been what? Also spent for the car. Okay.
So it will be what? 1,50,000 plus 10,000.
It will be what? 1,60,000. Can you write rupees? Okay, rupees. Okay, rupees 1,60,000. Okay, here also write rupees. Okay, rupees 1,60,000. Right.
SP equals to what? Selling price what? 2 lakhs. What selling price? What? 2 lakhs rupees. 2 lakhs. So in this case, right, since CP is less than SP, it is what? SP is what? Greater. So there is a profit. That means what? In this case, what? It is profit. Why? Because here 2 lakhs, here 1,60,000. So obviously, what? It is profit. Then how much profit? So, right. Therefore, profit equals to how much? 2 lakhs minus 1,60,000. Okay, there are rupees. It will be a 2 lakhs minus 1,60,000. It will be what? Rupees 40,000. Rupees what? Rupees 40,000. Rupees 40,000. Now this is the what answer. Now what? Number two. Binoy bought a house for 4,50,000. He spent 20,000 on repairs and whitewashing, and then sold it what for 4,30,000. Find his gain or loss. So obviously you see from the figure we can see what Binoy bought a house for what rupees 4,50,000. Then what? Then he spent also what more 20,000 on the what house, and it what sold for what 4,30,000. So obviously what it is loss. So let us find how much loss. Okay. So write. So question number two. Cost price for the house. Question number two. Cost price for the house. House equals to what? Rupees how much given? Cost price for the house equals to rupees how much? Yes, 4,50,000.
4,50,000.
Okay. Money spent in what? In repairs and whitewashing.
In repairs and whitewashing. Money spent in repairs. Repairs and whitewashing. Cost what?
Rupees what? Whitewashing rupees
20,000. 20,000.
Okay, therefore total CP will be what? Disperse this. So total CP will be what? 4,50,000. Okay. Rupees 4,50,000 plus 20,000. So obviously it will be what? Obviously it will be what? Rupees 4,50,000 plus 20 is 74,70,000. Okay. Rupees what? 4,70,000. Okay. Now write SP equals to. Now write SP for the house equals to what? How much given? SP for the house equals to how much given? SP for the house equals to 4,30,000. Okay, so write, since what? CP greater than SP. Okay, you see 4,30,000 and 4,70,000. So there is a loss. There is a loss. Therefore, loss equals to what? CP minus SP. Okay. So CP is what? 4,70,000. Okay. Minus 4,30,000. 4,30,000. So it is what? 4,70,000 minus 4,30,000. It will be only rupees 40,000. Okay, that is the what answer. Now come to question number 3. So question number 3, what is there? A dealer bought 50 quintals of rice at rupees 800 per quintal.
Okay, he paid rupees 400 as octroi charges and 600 as transportation charges. Then he sold the whole stock at 750 per quintal. Find his gain or loss. So what? First, what the dealer bought 50 quintals of rice at rupees 800 per quintal. Okay, that means what? Each quintal rupees what? Each quintal rupees what? 800. So for 50 will be what? 8 into 50. Then what? Then he what? Then he again paid what? Rupees 400 for octroi charges and 600 for what? Transportation. So this will be also what? This will be also what? All the total CP. Then after that what? He sold the stock what? At 750 per quintal. So 750 into what? 50 we shall find. Then we shall see which one is what? Greater and which one is what? Smaller. So you can understand what? Gain or loss. If SP is smaller than CP, then what? It is loss. And if SP is greater than CP, then what? It is profit.
So right. So question number 3, what is there? Right. Right. Question number 3. Right. Cost price for per quintal rice. Per episode 1 quintal. One quintal rice, what cost price for what? It is what cost price for what? One quintal rice, it is given what? Rupees 800. Therefore cost price for 50 quintal rice will be what? Rupees 50 into what? 800. It will be what? Rupees 40, then 3 zeros 40. Okay. Now what? Now he paid or right charges for 40 cost what? Rupees 400 and for transportation what? Rupees 600. And for our transportation rupees 600. Okay. Therefore total CP will be what? 40,000 plus 400 plus 600 rupees. Okay. So it will come what? 4 plus 6, it is what? 1000. It will come here 4100. Okay, 4000. What? 41,000. 40,000 plus 1000 is what? 41,000. So rupees. What? 41,000. Now what? Now see. SP for per quintal equals to what? Rupees 750. Now right. Now SP for 1 quintal
to start rupees 750. Therefore, SP for 50 quintal will be rupees 750 into what? 50.
Okay. So you multiply it, you get the answer. Multiply it what? You get the answer. So what? It will be, so here you can write, it will be rupees 5525 to zero put cost. 5525 and remain 2. Okay, 5735 36 37. So 37,500. 37,000 what? 500.
Now what? Find his gain or loss.
So in this case, you see total SP is what? 41,000. And what? He sell what? At rupees what? 37,000, what? 500. So in this case, what? It is loss. So right. Therefore, since what? CP is greater than SP. Therefore, there is a loss. Therefore, loss equals to, loss will be equal to 41 rupees. What? SCP minus, loss will be what? CP minus? CP minus what? SP. So CP is what? 41,000 minus what? SP. SP what? 37500. Rupees. So subtract it. So 41,000 and 37,500 10 minus 5, it is what? 5. Here remain what? 10. 10 minus 7, it is what? 3. Okay, so 3500.
So rupees 3500.
Okay, so that is the answer. Rupees 3500. Now come to question number 4. So question number 4, what is there? CP equals to what? 750. Overhead expense equals to what? 50. And profit equals to what? And profit equals to what? 80. So find gain or loss percent in what? So in the following. So obviously what? It has been given that what? It is profit. So we need to find what? We need to find what? Profit percent. Okay, and profit percent what? Formula equals to what? Total profit by cost price into 100. So you remember this formula. To find profit percent, the formula is what? Total profit by cost price into 100. So what? Total profit by cost price into what? 100. And in case of loss percent, it will be what? Loss by cost price. Just it will be loss into what? 100. So these are the two formula. Okay, we'll be using. So see question number one, what is there? Find the gain or loss percent in the following. So CP equals to what? 750. Overhead expense, that means more expense, what? Rupees 50. So total will be what? 750 plus 50. Okay, and profit given what? 80. So we need to find our profit percent. So see, So C 41 given what CP or SP? Yes, CP equals to rupees 750, comma, overhead expense. Overhead expense equals to what? Rupees 50. Okay. And profit equals to, profit equals to what? How many? 80%. 80%. Profit equals to what? 80%. So we need to find what? Sorry. Profit equals to what? Rupees 80. Rupees 80. Okay. Rupees 80. So right, therefore total CP will be what? This main cost price and overhead expense, this is also what? This is also what? One type of CP, because what? From with that what? Extra I have what? Spent rupees 50. So it will be added to what? Cost price. So it will be rupees 750 plus 50. It will be what? Rupees 800. Okay. Now what? Now profit. What profit percent we need to find? So profit percent, what formula? Total profit how much? Yes, 80 by what? CP. CP is what? Now this one is the main CP. 800 into what? 100. 0000 cancel. Okay. 8 1 8 8 10 80. It is what? 10%. It is what 10%. So now come to question number 3. CP 400, SP 460. So what? CP 400, SP 460. CP 400, SP 460. We need to find what? Gain or loss. So what? CP 400, SP 460. So obviously what? It is what? Obviously it is what? Obviously it is gain. Because what? Because he what? Buyed with what? 400 and sell with what? 460. So what? 60 rupees extra, it is what? Gain. So what? We need to find what? Gain percent. So right. CP equals to what? 400. CP equals to what? 400. Okay. Then what? SP equals to what? 460. Therefore, SP equals to what? Here you write rupees. Rupees what? 460. Therefore, write. Write. It is what? 43. Right, therefore, right, since SP greater than what? CP, it is profit. It is what? Profit. Since what? SP greater than CP. Okay, so it is what? Profit. Therefore, profit equals to what? SP minus CP. So SP how much? Rupees 460. Minus what? CP what? 400. So it is what? Rupees 60. Okay. Now what? We got the profit. Now we can find what? Now we can find what? Profit percent. It will be what? Profit percent will be what? Total profit what? 60 by CP is what? 400 into what? 100 according to the formula. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 15. It is what? 15%. It is what? 15%. So now one thing you see, question number 2 you see. So if I solve question number 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5 you can solve. So question number 2. 4, 2, what is there? So SP how much given? CP how much given? CP equals to what? 5200 rupees. And SB how much given? Rupees 5070. So in this case, one thing you see, CP what? 52 and SP what? 50. So obviously what it is? Loss. So write, since CP greater than SP, therefore it is loss. There is loss or it is loss, you can write anything. So therefore loss equals to how much? Let us find. So loss will be what? SP minus CP. So SP how much? 50. Sorry, CP minus SP. CP minus SP. So 5200 minus 5070. Okay. Yeah, rupees. So 5200 and 5070. Okay. 0. Yeah, 10. 10 minus 7. It is 3. Remain 2, 1. So 130. So loss is what? 130. So what? Rupees 130. Now what? Loss percent. Loss percent is what? Loss by CP. CP is what? 5200 into what? 100. Okay, now cancel it. Okay. Now what? 52. 2 2s are 4. Remain 1 6. 2 6 are 12. Now what? This one with 2. 2 7s are 2 5s are what? 2 5s are 10. And 2 6s are 12. You write 2 6s are 12. Remain 1. 2 5s are 10. Now this one, what? We need to what? Divide. So 130 is the what? Loss. So what? Loss equals to what? Loss equals to what? Total loss by cost price. So cost price how much? 5200 into what? 100. So what? I cut what? 2 zeros. Okay. So one thing you do like this. Make it short. What? Cost price how much? It was 130 by what? 52, okay, 52 into what? 100. So one thing you do, this zero you cancel, okay, and this zero you cancel, okay. So 13 ones are 13, 13 fours are what? 54. Now we cancel. 2 twos are 4, 5 twos are 10. So it is what? 5 by? It is what? 5 by 2. So divide. 5 by 2 will be what? 2 2s are 4, 1, 0, 2 5s are 10. 2.5. It will be what? 5 by 2 percent. Percent. It will be what? 2.5 percent. 2.5 percent. Okay. So that is the answer of question number 4. Now come to question number 5. So question number 5, all are same. I shall solve only one. Okay. So what? To solve question number 5, you need to write what? One formula. Okay. So write formula. So in this case, if you want to find SP, then you need to use this formula. Okay. The formula is that what? For solving question number 5, you need what? This formula. Whenever you will be asked to find SP and gain percent and CP are given, so at that time you can find SP like this. 100 plus gain percent. Okay. G percent, that means what? Just gain percent. Okay. or profit percent, anything, gain percent by what? 100 into what? SCP. CP will be given. So in this case, what you can find, what CP?
Okay, and whenever it will be given, what?
And whenever you find any loss, so in case of loss, you just, it will be 100 minus loss percent. Yes, okay, nothing more than that. And whenever you will be asked to find CP, so at that time this will just change. It will be what? 100, it will go up and this will come down. 100 by 100 plus gain or loss, anything, okay, into what? SP. Okay, so that will be the what?
Formula. Okay, 100 by 100 plus gain percent into SP,
and in case of loss, just it will be minus. Okay,
so all are same. So let us find. Okay, so question number one, let us find CP equals to what? Rupees 20, and gain equals to what? 10%.
Okay, so see, so here one thing you can write like this. Question number five, given what? CP equals to what? Rupees 20%. CP equals to what rupees 20, comma, gain equals to what? 10%. Therefore SP will be this formula. So 100 plus gain percent 10 by what? 100 into what? CP 20. Okay, so what, now you solve, it will be 110 by 100 into 20. Now cancel this one, you cancel this one, you cancel. Okay, so remain what? 11 to the what? 22. Okay, 11 to the what? 22. So SP will be what? Rupees 22. 11 to the what? 22. So question number 2, what? CP and loss given. So just what? You subtract this one loss, then you get the what? Answer. Okay, so come to question number 6. Find CP when SP equals to what? Okay, question number 6, same. And let me do here. Question number 6. SP given, you write. Given what? SP equals to how much? Given SP equals to 12 and gain equals to 20. SP rupees 12 and gain equals to what? 20%. Gain equals to what? 20%. Gain equals to what? 20%. Now what we need to find? What? CP. Therefore CP will be what? 100. That will just the opposite of this one. 100 by 100 plus 10. Sorry, 100 plus gain percent into what? 100 into what? SP. Okay, so 100 by 100 plus gain percent, how much? 20 into what? SP, how much? 12. So it will be what? So here one thing you can write, rupees also. Okay, so what? 100 by 120 into 12. Okay, 100 by 120 into 12. So one thing you can do, 0 cancel, this 12 cube cancel, so remain what? Rupees 10. This is what? Rupees 10. Okay, so SP equals to what? 360 and loss. So loss will be just here, you subtract it, then you get the answer. Okay, if you subtract, then it will become 90. So what? 100 by 90 into what? 360, then you get the answer. Okay,
क्वेश्चन 9C So what? Let me show one loss. Okay. What question number? Question number 6. 2UC. SP equals to how much? Given 360. Rupees 360. And loss equals to how much given? Loss equals to 10%. And we need to find what? CP. We need to find what CP. This thing you write given. Okay. We need to find what CP. Therefore, CP. CP will be what? If loss, then it will be just minus 100 minus loss percent. Okay. Into what? SP. So what? 100 minus loss. 100 minus loss. How much? 10%. Into what SP, how much? 360. Okay, now what? Here you write rupees. In every cases you write rupees. So what? Rupees. So 100 by 100 minus 10, it is 90. Into what? 360. Okay, now you can cancel this 0, this 0 you can cancel. And 91 jar 9 4 jar 36. Now what? So rupees 100 into 4, it is what? Rupees 400. So that is the what formula. So we apply in every cases. Okay, now come to question number 7. By selling a motorcycle for rupees 23,000, a dealer gains 15%. Find its what cost price. So it is worth nothing but question number 5. Okay, so see. Number 7, what? By selling a motorcycle, that means what? SP given. SP for the motorcycle equals to what? SP for the motorcycle equals to what? Rupees 23,000. Okay. And gain equals to what? 15%. And we need what? We need to find what cost price. Cost price we need to find. So what gain percent given cost price we need to find. Okay, we need to find what cost price. So it is what? 6. It is like question number 6. SP given. Okay, and gain given. So it will be what? Therefore CP will be what? It is what? We need to find CP. So it will be 100 by 100 plus 15 into what? SP, how much? 23,000. Okay, so it will be what? 100 by 115 into 23,000. Okay, 100 by 115 into what? 23,000. Now what you can sell? If you cancel this one with 5, then 5, 20s are. This one what? 5, 2 jar 10, 5, 3 jar 15. Okay? 5, 3 jar 15. What? 15. 100 by 100 plus gain. Okay? Into SP, so 23,000. Wait, this one what? 5 2s are 10, 23. Okay, now cancel this one.
will become what? 23 ones are 23 and remain 2 zeros. Okay.
Okay.
So if I now multiply, so 20 into 1000, it is what? 20,000. Rupees 20,000.
Okay, now come to question number 8. What is there? Let me show. The cost price of an article is 6250. Sudhir sells it at rupees what? 24%. Find its what? Selling price. So it is what? As like question number what? 5. So you practice. So question number 5 and question number 8 all are same. Cost price given what? 6250. And what? Loss given what? 24%. Okay, then find its what? Selling. So you will be what? We'll be writing just you, but just to apply this formula and find, okay, you'll be getting the answer. So what? Find the selling price. That means we need to find what? SP. So SP will be what? SP will be what? The formula is what? 100 minus what? Loss. 100 minus 24 by 100 into what? CP. CP is what? 6250. Okay, 6250. So if you cancel, then we'll get the answer. Okay, if you solve this one, then we'll get what? 4750. Okay, so it is like question number 5. Okay, just you put what? 1 minus, so we'll get the answer. Okay, now come to question number 14. A man bought a car for what? 60,000. Spent 10% of the cost. 10% of the cost of the car for purchase of a new tires. At what price should he sell the car to make a gain of 15%? So the question is asked that what a man what bought 60,000, a man what bought a car for what rupees 60,000, and he bought a what two tires for this car, and the cost price of the two tires is 10% of the 10% of the what amount with what the car has been bought. Okay, now to make 15% what to make 15% profit, at what rate the car should be sold to get a what 15% profit. So first you write CP of the car equals to what given. CP of the car is given what? 60,000. High order thinking skill. So what? CP for the car equals to what? CP for the car equals to? Yes. Right. Number 14. So CP for the car equals to what? 60,000, right? CP for the car equals to what? 60,000 rupees. CP for the car equals to what rupees? CP for the car equals to what rupees? 60,000. So expenditure on what? New tires. What cost price for the purchase of new tires, right? Therefore cost price CP for the purchase of two new tires, two new tires will be what? Two new tires will be what? 10% of the what? 10% of the total cost price. Okay, so 10% of the total cost price, it will be 10% of CP. Okay, total cost price, that means what? 10 by 100 into what? CP is what? 60,000. Okay, so cancel 0000 cancel. So what? 6000. Okay, rupees what?
6000. Okay, ₹6000. So total, now our total CP for the car will be what? ₹6000. So right, total, therefore total CP for the car will be what? This expenditure and the what old CP. So rupees what? 60,000 plus 6000. It will be what? Rupees how much? 66,000. Okay. Now what given? Now given what profit percent? Now profit percent given what? 15. So profit percent is given what? 15. 15%. Okay. So what? Now what profit? Now what? Now this profit percent will be what? Therefore, you write here, you write. Okay, write here. Therefore profit percent equals to what? How to find profit percent? It will be what? 15 is the profit. So 15 by 100 of what? This 15% is what? Rupees how much? So it will be what? 15% of rupees from this 66 I need to find. Okay, so 15 by 100 into what? 666. Okay, so 20 you can cancel, so remain what? 66 and 15. Okay, so what? 20 you can cancel, then first you multiply 66 and 15. Okay, so double line 0 and 10 is there, that means what? Double line 00. Okay, so it will be what? It will be what? Rupees double line 00. Rupees double line what? Double line 00. Okay, it will be what? Rupees double line 00. Now what? To gain profit of 15%, SP will be what? All right, because what? He need to what? Sell for the what? 15%. So right, to gain 15% profit, right, to gain 15% profit, SP equals to what? To gain 15% profit, SP will be what? Cost price, earlier cost price plus how much? Profit. So earlier cost price how? 66,000 plus what? Profit how much we got? 9,900. Okay, 9,900. So if you add, then you will get the answer. So 660, then 9,900. So what? 75900. That is what answer. Okay, he need to sell the what? He need to sell the what? Car at rupees what? 75900. Then he will get, then he will attain it, but then he will attain 15% profit. Okay, okay, now come to exercise 9D. Okay, next move to next exercise, that is what? Exercise 9D. So 9D, you see what? Question number 1, a man bought an article for rupees 25 and sold it for rupees 40. Okay, that means what? A man what? Bought a article for rupees 25 and sold it for rupees 40. So I think it is what? Here it is what? Profit. Another man bought article for rupees 50 and sold it at 65. Here also what? In both case what? In both cases it is what? Profit, I think. Okay. And what rate of profit is greater by what percent? That means what? In both case there are profit. Then which profit is greater and by what percent? Okay. So first we find the profit for the what? First person. Okay. So right. Nine D question number one. Nine D question number one. So write. For the first man. For the first man. For the first man, what? For the first man, how much given? For the first man, what given? For the first man, CP goes to what? Rupees 25. CP equals to what? Rupees 25. Okay. And what? SP equals to rupees 40. SP equals to what? Rupees 40. Therefore, what? Since, right? Since CP less than SP. It is what? Less than SP. Therefore it is, therefore what? Therefore it is what? Loss. Sorry, it is profit. Or right, there is a profit. There is a profit. Therefore profit will be what? SP minus CP. It is what? 40 minus what? 25. You write rupees 40 minus 25, it is what? 10 minus 5, it is 5. 4 minus 3, 4 here remain what? 3. 3 minus 2, it is what? 1. So what? Rupees 15, what? It is what? Profit. Now you can find what profit percent. Yes, we know what profit percent formula. So what profit percent will be what? Profit by what? Total CP into what? 100. So what profit by what? Total CP what? Into 100. So 25 4 jar what? So 25 4 jar 100. So 15 4 jar 60. So what? 60% first case. So now you find for the second, for the second man. For the second man, that is what? Another man. For another man, second man, how much cost price, how much given? Article for rupees 50 and selling price 65. So CP is what? CP goes to rupees 60 or 50. Rupees 50. And SP equals to what? Rupees 65. So right, since SP greater than CP, or you can write CP less than SP, there is a profit. What? There is a profit. Therefore SP will be what? Sorry, therefore profit will be what? SP minus CP. So rupees SP how much? 65 minus 50. Okay, so it will be what? 550. Okay, so 115. So what? In both case what? Profit coming what? Same. In both case what? Profit coming same. Now what? Now let us find what profit percent. Therefore, what profit percent will be what? What profit by what CP50 into what? 100. Okay. So 52 jar 100. So it will be what? 15 to jar. It is what? 30%. So what? Which one is? So which case? What rate of profit is greater than? And what? And by what rate of profit is greater and by what percent? So what first one is 60 and second one is what? 30. So you write, okay, I am telling by mouth, you write the what conclusion. So what will be? So obviously what? So in first case what? It is 60, okay, 60%, and by what percent? Okay, so what? First one is what? 60. Okay, so the first man got what? 60%. Okay, what rate of profit is greater? So which rate of profit is greater? 60. And by what percent? 60%. So it is what? 60%. So you write this answer. Now question number 2 and 3 is what? Almost same. Okay, so I am solving question number 3. Okay, so you can solve question number 2 from yourself. Okay, a woman bought 50 dozens eggs at 16. A dozen. Okay, that means what? What? She bought what? 50 dozens eggs at a dozen. Okay, so what? Then SP for what? Then CP for what? 50 dozen will be what? 12 into 50. It will be what? 600x. Okay. Okay, out of these 20x were found to be broken. So out of this what? 20 were found to be what? Broken. So what? We need to subtract 20 from the total. Okay, then she sold the remaining x at rupees 1.50 per egg. So find gain or loss percent. So what? Find gain or loss percent. So see how to find. This is easy. So what is given? First you write. She bought 50 dozen eggs at rupees 16. What? She bought 50 dozen eggs at rupees at a dozen. Okay, so right, she bought 50 dozen eggs at rupees 16 a dozen. So right, she bought option number 3. Okay, right, she bought 50 dozen eggs at rupees 16 a dozen. At rupees what? 16 a dozen. Okay, then what? Then cost price for the eggs will be what? 50 into 16. Then CP for the it will be what? 50 into what? 16. Because what? 16. So 15 dozen. So it will be what? 80. But what to find in the question? Let me see again.
quantity were found to be broken.
Yes, yes, it is correct. It will be what, rupees 800. Okay. Now what? Now we need to find what? Total number of eggs, how many? So here 50 dozen. So 50 into 12. Okay. So right, therefore, total numbers of egg will be what? 50 into 12. Because what? 1 dozen equals to what? 12 eggs. So 600 eggs. Okay. And from what? 600 eggs out of 20 eggs were found to be broken. So right. So right. Numbers. Right. Numbers of eggs broken. Just what? 20 eggs. Therefore, total numbers, therefore x remaining numbers of egg remains will be what? From total, if I subtract 20, then I'll get, okay, so it will be what? 580x. Okay, because what, total is what? 600. So from 600, what I subtracted what? 20, and I get what 580x. Now rest x has been what? Sent cell. Okay, that means what? SP for the rest x, and this was what? 1.50. because in the question it is said that what? She sold the remaining x, that means what? 580x at rupees what? 150 per egg. So for 580 will be what? 150 into 1.50 into what? 580. Okay, so we'll get what SP for the what? Remaining eggs. Okay, now after that what? We shall compare which one is greater, then we shall find. Okay, so right now SP for the remaining x will be what? 580 into what? What given? 1.5 or what? 5 into what? 1.50. Okay, it will be rupees. So here you write rupees, there is no space of rupees. Okay, so if I multiply, then I shall get, okay, so what? If you multiply, then you will get what? So multiply it. 5, 8 and what? 1, 5. 8, 7, 0. So what? 8, 7, 0. Okay, so write what? 8, 7, it will be what? 8, 7, 0, then what? 8, 7, 0, then what? 2 zeros remain. So point is after what? Before 2 digits. So if I take this one here, so it will be like this. So it will be 870 rupees. 870. Repeat what? 870. Here point is there. Okay. Rupees what? 870. So now you see. So what? Cost price what? How much? 800. And selling price what? 870. So what it is? What? It is what? It is gain. So what? Now we shall find what? Gain. Okay. So write. Question number 3. Okay. So what? Now write. Since SP greater than CP, okay, there is a profit. Profit. Therefore, profit equals to. So what? Profit will be what? Profit will be what? SP minus CP. Okay. So what? Rupees SP how much? 870 minus CP how much? 800. Okay. So it will be what? Rupees 70. So what? Rupees 70 is the what? Profit. Now what? Now you can find what? Now you can find profit percent. So how to find profit percent? We know the formula. Total profit by CP how much? 800 CP into what? 100 into what? Into what? 100 into what? 100. So what we can now we can find what? Now we can find CP percent. Okay. Now what? So we can cancel this one 0 0 0 0. So what? This one you can cancel what? 2 4 2 are 8. Okay. And 35 2 are. Okay. 4 2 are 8 and what? 35 2 are. Now what? We cannot divide further. So let us take 4 divided by 35. Remain what? 3. Then what point is there? 30. Okay. Then D8. Remain what? 8. Okay. Wait. Let me do. 4 8s are 32. Remain 3. Point is that take 10. Now what? 4 7s are 28. Remain 2. Point is that bring 0. Then 4 5s are 20. 8.75. Okay, 8.75. So what? I can write what? 35 divided by 4%. It is what? 8.75%. So what? That is the what answer? 8.75%. That is the what answer? Okay, so now come to question number 4. So what? Peter bought an article for rupees 1215 and spent 35 on its what? Transportation. At what price should he sell the article to gain what? 16%. So what? It is same. Okay. So what? Peter bought what? An article for rupees 1215 and spent what? 35 on its transportation. Okay. So what? So first you write CP for the article equals to what? Number 4. CP for the CP for the articles equals to how much? 1215. Rupees 1215. Okay. Then he spent 35 on his transportation. Okay. Money spent on transportation. Transportation will be what? Rupees what? How much given? Rupees one is spent on transportation, what, rupees 35, which rupees what, 35. Then what? Then total, then total CP for the article will be what? 1215 plus 35. Okay, here you write rupees. Rupees. So it will be what? 5 plus 5, 10. Okay. Then what? 3 plus 1, 4 and 1, 5. And what? 1, 2. Okay. So rupees 1250. What? Rupees 1250. Now what? Now how much? At what percent should he sell the article to gain 16%? So right, to gain 16%. So what? Now you need to find what? Profit. So right here. Here profit 16%. Here what profit equals to what? 16%. So it will be what? 16% of what? So profit will be what? 16% of. Therefore profit. Therefore what? Therefore what profit? What is the profit? Percent will be what? 16/100 into what? This one. This total CP. Okay. Now cancel. So if we cancel this one, 0, 0, cancel. Okay. Then what? 5, 2 are 10. And 5, 25 are 125. Okay. So 5, 2 are 10. 5, 2 are 10 and 5, 25 are. Now 2, 8 are 16. So what? 0, 8, 2 are 16. And plus 4, 200. It is what? 200. So what it is? 200. Therefore, what? Therefore, profit will be what? Now, now to gain profit of 16%, right? Therefore, to gain profit of 16%, comma SP will be what? This one, old CP. Okay, that is what? Total CP plus what? Profit, what will be? Okay. So what? 1250 plus what? 200. So add it, 1250 and 200. So it will be what? 1450. So it will be what? 1450 will be the what required selling price. Rupees 1450 will be the what required answer. Okay, so now come to question number 5. So question number 5, what is there? By selling a chair for rupees 30, a dealer makes a profit 25%. Then find what percent did the dealer pay for it. That means what? Then what? By selling a chair of rupees 30, that means what? By selling a chair of rupees 30, that means what? A person what? Sold a chair for rupees 30. And by selling this one, he gained profit 25%.
Now find what? Find what price did dealer pay for it? That now what? Now the dealer what pays? Okay, we need to find that one. So write. So what is given you? Write. Write SP. SP for the chair equals to rupees 30.
Number 5. SP for the chair equals to rupees what?
30.
SP for the chair equals to what? Rupees 30. Now what? Now what profit percent given? How much?
Now write
profit percent for the chair equals to what? How much he gained profit?
It is what? 25%.
It is what? 25%.
So what SP for the chair is what? 30. That means what? He sold the chair for 30, and by selling 30 he got what? 25% what? As a what? Profit. Now what? Now we need to find what? CP. Therefore what? That means what? Cost price we need to find. The question is asked about what? Cost price. So it will be what? Cost price will be what? We know that one, that earlier formula, 100 plus what? 100 plus gain. Okay, gain or profit percent. Okay, 100 plus profit percent into what? SP. To what? SP. Okay, so what? Rupees. It will be what? 100 by what? 100 plus profit 25% into SP. How much? Rupees 30. Okay, now what? Cancel it. So 100 by 125 into what? Rupees 30. Okay, then what? Now you cancel with 5 6 are 30. Okay, and 525 are what? 125. Now 25 1 25 1 25, and what? 25 4 are what? Okay, 100. That is what? Rupees 4 into 6, it is what? 24. So what? Rupees 24. So what? Find price did the dealer pay for it. Right, the required price did the dealer pay? The required price did the dealer pay equals to rupees what? Rupees 24. Equals to what? Rupees 24. Okay, now come to what? Question number 6. So question number 6, what is there? Sharita bought X at rupees 8.40 a dozen. At what price per hundred must we sell them so as to earn a profit of what? 15%. So as to what? Earn a profit of what? 15%. So what? Sharita bought X at rupees what? 8.40 a dozen. That means what? The cost of one dozen is what? 8.40. Then what? Then for the cost of what? 1x will be. Then for what? Then what? What price per 100 must be sell them so as to get what? A profit of what? 12 dozen. At what price per 100 must be sell? At what price per 100 must we sell them so as to earn a profit of what? 15%. So what we need to find, what the selling price for, what the selling price for 15%, okay, profit, with profit, okay. So write cost price for cost price for what 12 x will be what. So cost price for what 12 x, that means what, a dozen x.
So write cost price for a dozen, right, a dozen x, a dozen, that means what 12, okay.
So what is given, what cost price to the edge, what 8.40
rupees is what, rupees what 8.40, okay.
Now what cost price for 1 dozen will be what, sorry, cost price for what,
cost price for 1 x will be, cost price for what 1 x will be what 840 by what 12, because here what a dozen, that means what 12. So if I want to find the cost price for 1, then what it will be divided by what 12. So what I can find what 1.
Okay, so if I divide it, then what, then I'll get what answer. So what 12 7 jar 84.
So what 12 7 jar, what 84 7 jar. So here what 1 point is there, so it will be what
point 8.40. So 1 point is there, for that reason it will be what 0.7.
So what rupees what 0.7,
rupees what 0.7, okay. Now for what, now cost of 100 x will be what, therefore cost of 100 x will be what 0.7 into 100, okay. So 0.7 into what, 0.7 into what 100. So if we multiply, then two places it will go, here what one places, so it will go two places like this, 7.00. Here point is there, okay. So it will be what rupees 70, okay.
What now we, what we got the what cost price for what 100 x will be what 70.
Now what, now we can say that what CP equals to rupees 70. Now right, therefore CP for the 100 x equals to what rupees 70. Now what we need to what sell it at what at 15% profit, therefore write profit percent equals to what 15%, that means what we need to find, what we need to find what SP. So we know that one, that SP will be what 100 plus what profit by CP into 100, sorry, 100 plus profit by 100 into what CP. So here you write, here I am writing, okay, therefore SP will be what 100 plus profit, okay, by 100 into what cost price is what 70. We got what cost price 70 for 100 x, okay, for 100 x there will be what 70. So now you what cancel 115 by 100 into what 70. So if you cancel, then this zero what get cancelled, then if I cancel, then 5 with 5 5 twos are, okay, then this one if I cancel, then what 5 how much 5 twos are, then this one what 5 1 jar 5 5 2 jar 10, 5 3 jar what 15. So remain what 23 into 7, okay. So what remain, so what
Now what? Now you can divide. Okay. Or one thing you can do like this. What? One thing you do, it will be better. Then the cancellation will be what? Easy. So what? 115 by 100 into what? 70. So you cancel this 0 and this 0. Then you multiply this one. Then here 115 into 7 by what? 10. Then if you cancel, then it will, then we can do easily. So 115 into 7, it will be what? 35. I remain 3. 7 under 7, 10. Remain what? 1. Okay. Then 7 under 7 and 1, 8. 805. So 805 by what? 100. Sorry, 10. So 805 by. So here in all cases you write rupees. Rupees you write. Okay. I am missing rupees. Rupees. So if you divide by what? 10. If you divide by 10, so here you write answer. So if you divide by 10 this one, then what? The point will come one place left. So it will be what? Rupees 80.5. Rupees what? Rupees 80.5. 0 or 5, anything you can give. Okay. Rupees 80.50 or 5, anything you can give. Okay. Now what? Now come to question number 7. What is there? If the CP of 16 article is equals to SP of 4 articles, then what? Then what? Find the gain percent. Find the what? Gain percent. So obviously what you see, CP for 6 articles is equals to SP for what? 4 articles. Then what? Find the gain percent. So right, let the CP for, just we're letting, okay, we don't know, so let the CP for what? 1 article be what? Rupee 1. So right, okay, so right, let the question number 7, let the what? CP for 1 article, let the CP for what? 1 article be what? 1 article be rupees what? 1. Okay. Let the CP for rupees 1 article be what? 1. Okay. The CP for 4 article will be what? Be rupee 1. Be what? Rupee 1. Okay. Okay. Sorry, rupees 1. Okay. So what? Now what? Now CP for 4 articles will be what? CP for 4 articles will be. Therefore, CP for 4 articles will be what? 4 into 1, rupees 4 into 1, because 1 article rupees 1, so 4 article will be what? 4 into 1. Okay, rupees what? 4 into 1, that is what? Rupees 4 into 1, that is what? Rupees 4, that is what? Rupees 4. Now what? SP for 4 articles equals to what? CP for 6 articles. So what? SP, therefore write SP for, it is according to question. Okay, SP for 4 articles equals to what? CP for 6 articles, that is what? SP for 4 articles is equals to what? CP for what? CP for 6 articles, it is given. Here you see, it is given the question that CP for 6 articles is equals to SP for 4 articles. So SP for 4 articles will be what? CP for 6 articles, that is what? That is what? 6 into 1, rupees 6 into 1, which is what? Rupees 6. Okay.
rupees 6 what we can write, okay. Now what? Now let us see which one is greater. SP is 6 and CP is what, 4. So write, since CP less than SP, since CP less than SP, therefore there is a gain, and it is said in the question also. Okay, now what? Now we need to find what gain, how much gain is there. Gain will be what? SP minus CP. Okay, so SP is how much? SP is how much given? 6 minus CP how much? 4. Okay, it is what? Rupees 2. Okay, now what? Now we know what gain percent is. What gain by what? What gain by what? CP into what? 100. So here you write, then you come here. Therefore what? Gain percent goes to what? Gain by 100, sorry, gain by CP into what? 100. So gain how much? Gain what? 2. CP how much? 4 into what? 100. So 4 how many there? 425 there. And 2 into 5 it is how much? 50. So it is what? How much gain? 50% gain. How much gain it is what? 50% gain. Okay. So now come to question number 8. A man buys toffees at ten for 3 and sells them eight for 3. Find his gain percent. It is also what? Same. Okay. So let me do. So first you find what? Given CP for what? 10 toffees. So right. Given CP for 10 toffees. So write given number 8. Given CP for 10 toffees. CP for 10 toffees. Okay. So given what? CP for 10 toffees equals to how much? Rupees 3. It is given. Sold what? By 10 toffees at rupees 3. So at rupees 3, okay, at rupees 3, okay. So 1 will be what? Therefore CP for 1 toffee will be what? 3 by 10, okay. Rupees what? Rupees 3 by 10. Now what? Now SP for the 8 toffees will be what? And SP for how much given? SP for what? SP for 8. SP for what? 3 toffees. Yes. What given? 10. SP for buys toffees at 10 for 3 and sells them 8 for 3. So SP for 3. What? And SP for 8 toffees SP for 8 toffees at what? Rupees at rupees what? 3. Okay, therefore SP for 1 toffee will be what? Rupees 3 by 8. Rupees what? Rupees 3 by 8. Now what? So obviously you see 3 by 8 and what? 3 by 10 and 3 by 8. So from this we can understand what? Which one is what? Here gain or loss. So what? Obviously what it is said in the question, that what
find his gain percent. So that means what? It is said that it is gain. So what we know what gain? So therefore, gain will be what? SP minus CP. SP minus what? CP. It is already gain, and you can check also like this by, you see, 3 by 10 and 3 by 8. So if I make, so if I multiply with 8, then it is what? 24 by 80. By making that numerator same, which one is greater? So 8 tens are 24. It is given in the question, or not to find. It is given in the question. It is what? That it is given in the question. It is what? It is already gain. So what? Directly we can write what? SP minus CP. So SP is what? 3 by 8. Okay. And what? And what? CP is what? 3 by 10. So you can find what? 8 and 10. What? LCM will be how much? 8 and 10. LCM, let us take. 8 and 10. LCM. 2 4s are 8. 2 5s are 10. With 4, 1, 5 remain. Again with what? 5, 1. So 4 5s are 20. 22s are 40. So it is what? 40 is the what? LCM. So if I take 40 as a LCM, then what? How much? 5 8s are 40. 5 3s are 15. Then 4 3s are, it is what? 12. So what? 2 by what? 2 by 40. Oh, sorry, 3 by 40. Sorry. 3 by 40. Okay. Because what? 15 minus 12, it is what? 3 by 40. So what we got? What? Gain equals to what? Rupees 3 by 40. Is what? 3 by 40. Now we need to find what? Gain percent. So gain percent will be what? Gain percent will be what? Gain by what? CP. Okay. Gain by what? CP into 100. So what? Gain how much? 3 by 8. Okay. By what? CP. CP how much? 3 by 10. So 3 by 10 into what? 100. Okay. Now solve it. So if I solve, then 3 by 8 into this will go up and this will come down. Okay. Into what? 100. Now cancel. This 3, 3 got cancelled. Okay. And here I can write 4. If I cancel with 2, then 4. 4, 2 are 8. Okay. And 2, 5 are 10. Okay. Then 4 1s are 4, 4 5s are what? Sorry. 4 25s are what? 4 25s are? 3 by 40. Here I did know what? 3 by 8. So you write again here. This is what? 3 by 40. Okay. Then what? 3 by 40. Then what? 3 by 10 into what? 100. Now what? Now you can guess yourself. 3 by 40 into what? 10 by 3 into what? 100. How can cancel this 0, this 0 you can cancel. Okay, 3, 3 you can cancel. And 4, 25 are what? 100. So it is what? 25%. That is the what? Answer. So today up to this, and if you find any problem, then you can call me at night. Thank you very much.